Lights, camera, action!
I found out that for the 40th anniversary of the release of E.T. the Extraterrestrial, my local movie theater was showing it in IMAX. So, got myself a ticket. But before I went to the theater, I went to the bar. Had a beer. I know. But look, I just wanted something that I knew I could drink at the bar while I waited for the movie to start.
All right, kids. Time to go see E.T. I can't even front. I was in here crying like a big old baby at the end of E.T., boy. I was in here crying. Niagara Falls.
And afterward, I went back to the bar. This time, had an old 43. And also, made some new friends.
So yeah, I actually went to the bar, met a couple of folks, met a dude from the Bronx, and his girlfriend, who is from out here. Shout out to Joe, shout out to Stacy. Y'all are fucking awesome.
Yeah, I came out here to see E.T. the Extraterrestrial, a film that I haven't seen in years, and it was reconfigured or whatever, I don't know, for IMAX for its 40th anniversary. I'm gonna be very real with y'all. E.T. is a fucking exceptional film. It's a phenomenal film. It is absolutely a masterclass in filmmaking. And for me, it really does exemplify the best of the 80s. The best of 80s cinema. And I'm very much a fan of 80s cinema because I grew up on 80s cinema because I'm old. And I'm talking about everything. Everything from the cinematography and the kind of like mise-en-scene, to like how tight the screenplay is, to the fucking score by John Williams. It's so, oh my God. And the performances. I mean, the performances are just out of this world. Like your man who plays Elliot, I forget his name, Henry Thomas. I forget his name right now, but he is just incredible as Elliot. And everybody else, I mean, Dee Wallace, she's great as Mary, the clueless mother who doesn't even know this is happening underneath like her roof. Drew Barrymore is hilarious as Gertie. And for anyone who has read Potter's Field, there is a Gertie shout out in that script. There's always been the Gertie shout out, so I'm just throwing that out there. Michael Naughton as the older brother, like the entire film. Look, it's just so well written, so well directed, so well shot, so well scored. This really is a perfect film. And that was the thing, because going into it, I was just kind of like, does it hold up? Sure, it was the biggest movie in the world for the longest time, but does it really hold up? And I can say yes, it does. It does. Some people may be put off by the dated effects. And I'm just like, you know, for 1982, they were state-of-the-art effects. But even still, E.T. himself as a character is just fucking amazing. It's an amazing achievement in special effects. And you really believe that E.T. is a character. Like, you don't think to yourself, oh, this is like a puppet or some, you know, CGI creature that they know. You're just like, you're there with E.T. And I forget who voices E.T. I think it's the same person who voiced the demon in The Exorcist. But I might be wrong. But in any case, the person who voices E.T. really gives E.T. like that just sympathetic quality. You know, once E.T. starts talking, you're just like, oh, he can communicate and he understands. It's just like, oh my God. And, you know, like I said, I was at the end. I was crying like a big old baby. Tears were coming down my face, and I was really surprised. Even though I knew how the film was going to end because I've seen it 1,000 times, I was really surprised at how much it affected me emotionally. And yes, my ass was in there crying, tears, Niagara Falls. I was just like, damn. And the final thing, I really just love how tight it is as a film. Like, E.T. might be 2 hours long, but it's just like, from the opening credits, there's really no like flourish. It's just like E.T. starring, written by, produced by, directed by Spielberg. And then the film starts, and it takes you on this journey that feels simultaneously epic and intimate. And that's where E.T. really, 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 really excels. Because you will come away from this movie feeling like you've seen like the biggest fucking epic film of your life. It's really a small story. It's a small story about this kid and his relationship with this alien who becomes his best friend or whatever. It's a very, very intimate story. And I think that point hits home in the end. And it's just magnificent. Magnificent and magical. And it's something that films today don't do. Movies today don't hit you like this. Like, I found myself cheering, and I've seen this movie 1,000 times before tonight. And I found myself cheering, like, toward the end when Michael, the older brother, is just like, get the bikes and meet us at the playground. And they all meet up at the playground, then they have to evade the police. It's just like, that sort of thing, we don't see that in movies today, you know. And I don't know why, and I'm saddened by it, but that's the kind of thing that I want my movies to have, that kind of magical feeling in the run-up to the climax. Like, it's just awesome. It's awesome. And I'm very happy that we got the version of the film that has the guns. Fuck all the PC shit. I'm glad that the government agents had guns in their hands and not walkie-talkies, because fuck that bullshit. Oh my God, the agents have guns. They're federal fucking agents. Of course they have guns. This is a fucking alien. What are you talking about? So I'm glad that my screening of E.T. featured the version that had agents with guns. Again, just a brilliant, brilliant film. And that's what I was getting into. I'm sorry. I've been drinking. It starts off where it needs to, and it cuts off right at the end. When E.T. gets back to his ship, and he says his goodbyes to everybody, and then the ship takes off, and that's it. There's no extra shit. The movie ends. Perfect movie. E.T. really is a perfect movie. Look, I like Gandhi. I like Richard Attenborough. But goddamn, I really honestly don't see how. Maybe it's because Gandhi was a big spectacle and a big budget kind of blah. But I honestly don't. I don't see how E.T. lost to Gandhi Best Picture. I just don't. This movie is. And it's, you know, the type of film that I aspire to make. Like, seeing this on the big screen in IMAX, like, it really kind of hits for me, like, this is, what the shit is going on? This is the scale and scope of movie that I want to make. It has the look and the humor and the heart of the type of movie that I would like to make, that I'm going to make. I'm going to say that, so, yeah. If you have not seen E.T., I don't even know where or how E.T. is available. Whether it's streaming, Blu-ray, DVD, like whatever. But if you have not seen E.T. the Extraterrestrial, You're doing yourself a disservice. Please, please, please. I am so glad that I saw it again in the theater. It was one of the earliest films that I saw as a child in theaters because my mom took me to see it. And I know we saw it several times in the theaters because that's what it was back then. And then when it was released on VHS, years after its theatrical, we got it. And of course, we watched it again and again. But if you haven't seen E.T., please do so. It's just an amazing film. It's a great film. If this was the only film that Steven Spielberg ever directed, he would still go down in history as like one of the greatest. That's pretty much all I can, that's the only way I can put it. So yeah, all right, I am still high off of E.T. and I'm full of liquor thanks to Joe and Stacy. Y'all are the real MVPs tonight. Gonna try to figure out some food situation because I'm probably not gonna eat what I have at the house. So this will be a fast food situation, and I don't know where I am calorically. I can't believe I'm counting calories. God, I'm fucking old and fat. But I don't know where I'm at calorically, and right now I don't care. I just want to get some food to satisfy my hunger and to go to bed tonight. And you know, yeah. That's it. Vlog every day in August. I'll see y'all in the next one.